Hello, hello. Good evening, everyone. How are you guys doing? I hope you are all well. We are starting one more round of Formula 1 21. And today's agenda will be starting with Canada, then we will go to Monza. In Canada, we will be doing a little bit of practice that we need to complete and then going to qualifying. And because the Canada one is a weekly event, we cannot progress to the race until the weekend. Then in Monza, we as well need to do some practice and then we're gonna jump into qualifying, but that is on my team career mode and we can play around, go back and forth and do whatever we want with my career mode basically, which is great. And on in for the Canada event is a weekly event, so you're gonna be against online people, so the guys are gonna be doing practice at the same time. It's always very exciting and very, we need to be very careful as well because you can easily mess up your qualifying, just be out of it. Very easy to get out of it if you're not completely focused. And this week is race week, so Canada is coming up in Formula One. There's a lot of talk around porpoising again due to the whole issue with with Hamilton, with almost destroyed his back, and as well Leclerc and Sainz, all the issues that they had with bouncing and purposing, that is still talking a lot about it. And there is really good videos, not new videos, by Formula One and by, I forgot now his name, Driver 61, I think that's his channel. Really good with the guy Scarbs, I think is his name. Yeah, really, really nice explaining, giving options, possible solutions for the teams for Formula One regarding to the whole porpoising thing. Just checking here if we are live. I believe we are. Everything should be good. Let's check our chat. Check our sound. Yeah, sounding good. So thanks again guys for coming by. Thanks for everyone that comes and say hello in the channel. We stream mainly Formula One. Hopefully we will get Formula One 22, 2022. There is so many updates and it's looking pretty cool. The game's gonna be released 1st of July, so we'll see if we can manage to get it. It's around 80 euros, quite expensive, but it's really worth it. The game is looking stunning, really cool. There is a few videos as well already by Jano Ophemer, Marcel Kiefer, they are all posting a few videos from the game, which is really cool. So that's usually in the channel. That's what we stream, Formula One, and we chat about it as well with the guys that comes here. We chat about the weekend races and all this stuff. Always having fun and chatting and yeah, having a good time. That's the main purpose. I always upload my streamings to my channel in YouTube, Marcelo F1 Streaming. And Sometimes when I have time, I post as well in TikTok and Instagram and other social medias. All the links are there on my description. In Twitch, you can find all the links there. Even Discord, there is as well. Sometimes I go there, check, and we exchange information with the guys there. I love technology and love engineering. And I always enjoyed cars, Formula One, auto sports in general. So it's always nice to be able to do it. So we are here every Tuesday, Thursday, Sundays, and around 7:30. That's more or less the schedule that we do here in the channel. Cool. So I've watched a video about the setup for Canada. We're gonna try that, and we will try Jarno Opmyr as well. His setup for Monza. I checked his setup for Monza. We always need to adapt. Like you can always get those setups for reference, and then after you do some tweaks to your driving style, to the gear you have as well, the way you feel, the force feedback and things can vary depending of the equipment you have, and so you might need to adapt it to what you have. But it's always fun to test it, check it out, what they are doing, try it out and see how it behaves, how the car behaves, and learn from it. It's always cool. So let's go. This setup I have here is the same I had before. So I start to do some work on the balance of the tires to try to get a more uniform usage. Nothing special here. This is for Canada, right? So front, very soft, everything the minimum. Rear, getting to the middle and still in a soft suspension. Then front right height very low here for Canada. We probably will be moving this to 2 because of the curbs, and 7 on the rear. That's the standard, and nothing special. And here we have very strong front end with the front wing with 10. So I saw a setup with 6 with lower front wing. So that's what we're gonna compare today. In the beginning, we will start with this one, the higher front end wing, and then we'll move on to our lower front wing. Lots of torches with the wall. Thank you. very difficult to get that she can properly. As I have ride height 1 in the front, I need to be extra careful on how I get those curbs, because it might throw me off. Turn to get it. Just fix one thing here. One sec. Okay, we do this one and one more lap, and then we change our setup to test. Oh, now it's stopping. I'm getting the my braking warmed up. Oops, that's too much. Let's test these curbs here. Let's test it here. Probably because the suspension is so soft. I only realized that I have the racing light on now. So let's do our changes to 6. Let's go. New setup. Oh, it's turning much easier. Looks like. A little change on the front brake bias and differential. Very easy to miss that corner. I can't get the curb. It seems to be working. Seems to be working. Let's go check. So we have 6, 8. That's all right. 54 here, and I think we can do something extreme like this. And test it out. I want to maybe put. He knows when I'm not holding the thing. Let's remove that tracing line. Lots of corner cutting there, but it's still valid. DRS. Not too late. Too late. Lots of understeering. There we go. Nice DRS. special made to break. Okay, let's go back.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 15.0.
My response there. Too late. Very close to the wall. I think I found a good compromise on the setup. Wrong braking, but it worked. Second DRS. DRS. And how much? think this might work. Need to add a little bit of rotation. What can we do? Head into garage. Off throttle or two, let's see this slight change. Yeah, I think I can see the car moving already. That was abusing. One 14, nice. So let's save it. Okay, let's save this. This is Canada. So now go to Monza. Maybe it's called Italy, yeah. Electroplat, what's that? 114. I don't remember how much the fastest guy was doing there. So now we're gonna do a test for Monza with Ianoab Mir, the setup that he showed on his video on YouTube for Monza Formula 2021. Let's check the leaderboard. So the fast guys, they are doing 118. Let's load Monza and have a look what we have at the moment. Okay, now this is the one we got from online. We can already change this, and we're gonna put straight the one that I saw from him, which was 5-3. Front wing 5, rear wing 3, transmission, that's alright, I think they had like 56, suspension standard, then here was like 2, here actual, think was 1, 9, was 2-6, and bias, this varies as well. Just leave it like this, I think here was that. I'm gonna confirm. Very easy. Next time I can just like take a screenshot. That's gonna be easy to remember. Three. That was that normal, yeah, standard. Then here, yeah, it has 7, but then he puts 2-2-1-9-2-6. To add some rotation, so 2-4-1-9-2-6. Five, Yeah. 23.21.1. So we're gonna take this one for reference, and we're gonna progress from it. Save. Exit, and let's try it out. Where's the next kill? One gear didn't come down. Sometimes it feels like even though I click, it doesn't change. Feels good though. The problem is we need to learn the track and the braking points, the turns, but on a straight is flying. Oh, look at that turn. It turns very easy. Nice grip. Then we need to learn how to do that turn. Let's check the racing line for this track is settings custom. Let's do one lap into the racing line. There's no more gears. Maximum speed. Sometimes the racing line with the breaking point doesn't seem realistic if you break a that you really need to be on it to stop the car. Very close. Not bad.
That last lap was at
1:27. So was 1:18. None of the fastest guys. We have a good 9 seconds to beat, and I'm curious to see the behavior here with the car. So he had this on 7 before he put on, and this on 2. No. So 9, 1, 4, 7. I think it was only this only one. Yeah. Let's see. Might be too bumpy over the curves. Oh, I can feel that my steering wheel much more grippy. It's working, I must say. Ah, come on. That would be a flying lap. How much? 1:25. That would be a fine lap there. We get 2 seconds. So let's... What was it? Two things. One, I think I need a little bit more wheel damper. Save. Wheel temperature 4. And let's go to start it up. those curbs. Too much of those curbs. There is a. Boom. Fine. Now, here. The banana. The banana. One more lap and we start with the practice for calendar and qualifying. Okay, let's go. So let's save it. That's good. Let's save. This is Monza. Look, 118. We are 126, and look how many thousand people in front. Just with 118, 119, so many. We can do 119 there. Wow, yeah, so many can do the 119. One practice remaining. 10 days. Let's go to that practice. Canada. Let's get our setup. Canada. 7, 8, 54, 2, 1, 2, 1, 9, 2, 7.
Report's good. We're looking at a dry session.
Okay. So, car is ready. Practice 1, practice 3. Race strategy, full management, and qualified base. Race strategy, start.
Let's get a few laps under our belt.
Yeah. Now we're gonna check on the weekly event if the setup works. The tires are not gripping yet.
When you're ready, let's go.
That's very close. Again.
Try again. good. We need you to improve on that.
The chicane is stealing
okay, test over,
time.
I'm afraid we didn't get what we needed. We're gonna have to run it again.
What's that little number one in front of my name? So the best was, my best was 117. Oops. Well, 16 front is okay, right is a bit lower, okay, rear right can fix a little bit. That was completely my fault. I took the guy out of the practice, probably broke his car. I want to give him space and up closing on him probably.
Our best lap so far is a 1 minute 17.4.
Right. Okay. Okay. Yes.
probably goes without saying, but don't be too greedy on the throttle coming out of the turn 10 hairpin. It can trick you into thinking you've nailed the perfect line, then you get on the power and understeer into the barrier. Be a bit patient or take a later apex here. All set.
Everyone all set.
Car to track.
That was how to remove someone from the practice. Poor guy. 1-1, I'm back with that tires again. Let's check how it's going. What? Ah, this penalty, I think. The number one beside my name. Unless I have the best time. That was my tires. Nice chicane this time.
Okay, you weren't quite good enough that lap. Try again. complete, and that was a very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that.
Tires are much closer now, 8 and 10, 10 and 10. We can try to improve the balance a little bit more even still. It's gonna be natural that there is more degradation on the rear tires due to the characteristics of the track and the traction that we need every time. So it's quite good already, we can leave it like that. Because actually the car is driving quite nicely, so if we change more the tire pressure, we might end up breaking things. So we have 7 minutes, we can actually do this test. I put it the left, right, the right, a little bit down still, and
the car settings screen on your multifunction display will allow you to change various settings as you drive. Open the display with the MFD button. You can then navigate up and down to the setting you want to change. Checks complete. We're ready.
So, let's see if we broke the setup now or if it's still working. We have about 6 minutes. Yep. Eyes, I used the tire. she's knowing that she came.
Well, program over, but that wasn't much help to us. We need it again, I'm afraid.
Wow, 115. I fixed the balance. Oh, look, the tire is looking much better.
Please box this lap. When driving with a pit assist disabled, you'll need to be mindful of your speed when entering the pit lane. If you hit the limiter line too fast, you'll pick up a penalty.
I'm gonna go for one more lap.
Target speed and distance to the limiter line. Okay, just want to remind you to keep an eye on your tire temperatures, which you can do on the temperature panel of the MFD. We monitor carcass temperature and surface temperature, and you'll get the best performance when they're both inside a normal operating window. Surface temps tend to fluctuate faster, so try a few laps with the data open.
That was a very nice turnaround, but it was not accepted. Got disqualified because of that little maneuver. Advanced to qualifying, and this is it. Qualifying, let's go. Okay, let's check the car setup if it's still good. 6, 8, 4. Yes, 2, 4. 1, 8, 2, 7. I think this is right. Right and right. Yeah.
The forecast is good for this session. Dry weather all the way.
Save. This is Canada. Just to make sure that is Canada, right? Yeah, Canada. Okay, make sure that this saved. Otherwise we finish the session and then says, and then it doesn't save the setup. Tires, so qualifying race, sunny. Soft and mediums. Let's start on the mediums. No, let's do soft and do our best with the softs. As the track is still fresh and things seems to be going well. Still qualifying. There was a shade on my mark. Early. Lost a little bit of focus there. The traffic is spoiling my lap. Let's go again. Traffic spoiled our lap. It's very much used now.
Our best lap so far is a 1:15.9. Everyone ready? Okay, let's go.
Let's risk. Let's go mediums. Okay, let's go. Let's put some softs. And try our first lap. Didn't manage to get a nice run with the softs, with the mediums.
Track is pretty quiet at the moment. Perhaps we should get out there and get a few laps in. Engine fired.
That's what we're gonna do, my friend. Okay, new sets of tires. Still not working yet, still not gripping so well. Remaining. look at those tire usage. Perfect. Three. So we found the right balance for the car with the tire pressure. Let me show you guys. So we now have pole position with the time of 1:15. Best time of the practice of the online race for these guys that are online now at the moment. This is second. They are the guys that are on the track. And I am first. I got a pole with 1:15.622. That was an amazing lap. I do have, I think, a penalty for the crash on the practice tour. Something happened there. Probably that guy got his too. And car setup. So we have this and the tires for the balance. That's nice for
Our
my
best lap so
setup.
far is a 1:15.6.
So that was the nice arrangement with the tires to get the proper usage balance. And the car really felt more stable as well. I could attack the corners with much more confidence. I still missing the chicanes. It's very tough to get the chicanes properly done, but we managed to get. Look, and with no assists there. Position 5238 with a time of 1:15.622. That is pretty cool. Let's see. I think the communicator line services. Like 1:15, this is a lot of people in 1:15. 1:15, 1:15, not 1:14. Wow. Yeah. We managed to get to the 1:15s, 600, so it's cool. Can definitely improve by still doing like, chicanes not so well done. And sometimes I do in fourth, sometimes I do in third gear, not consistent there. As soon as I get, but all the other places I kind of have more or less a standard where to go. This is my time, and the next one is the race, which is gonna open only on the weekends. And this is it for the weekly event, practice and qualifying. Happy for the first time getting pole position for the event with the guys that are online at the moment. Blistering lap, car set up nicely, so happy with that. Really happy. So before diving into Monza, I think I'm gonna get a somewhat and I'll be back. Just get some water to sec.
Okay, let's talk about this track. The chicane at turns 4 and 5 is the Variante della Roggia. Err on the side of braking early, rather than risk braking too late. You might lose a bit of speed braking too soon, but as long as you're on the right line, it won't be too bad. Brake too late, though, and you'll miss the first apex entirely and lose momentum all the way down to the Lesmos. To view information on your current levels of tire wear and damage, press the MFD button to open the multifunction display, and then again to cycle to the tires and damage screen. We have a number of programs to run during these practice sessions. You can check the details in the car monitor. We'll get good data for both the race and factory teams, so they're well worth running. Okay, the circuit is clear at the moment. We're good to go.
Good, good. Let's start now. Monza.
Okay, just want to remind you to keep an eye on your tyre usage. We have to give two sets back at the end of this session, so they'll be unavailable.
Cool, so we're starting this practice session. I think this is practice number 1 or 2. Practice number 1, maybe. Ah, practice number 2. Cool. So, we have mediums and hard softs. Everything to choose. Let's load our car setup. Monza. And this one, that's the one we copy from Iano Opmi. He starts with 7 and he changed to 2, which gives more
quick note about turn. Tires. Just bear in mind we have to return the 2 most worn sets at the end of this session. They're gone forever at that point, so be careful how and when you use them, and don't waste any sets that you might need later on.
Thanks, Jeff. So I put 7 and I kind of liked it because I just felt that I had more response on my wheel. on completely soft, it felt to lose. So we it worked for me. So that's the only change we've done. And let's go and see if we need to do more changes, because that setting was for time trial. So now we are on the my team carry mode with my own car, and the engine and might be not that amazing. The temperature and the tires are different. So let's see how this setup's gonna work. I feel the difference already from Canada to here. Let's remove this racing line. No, let's do one lap with the race line. Oh, those curbs are really hurting. Oh, look at the tire usage. I might need to adjust the tire usage. So let's remove this racing line. Let's go. Track acclimatization for Monza. Oh. That was not a good start. Oh, all the way up there.
What happened? Let me know you're okay.
Straight to the barrier. We started with the left foot. Let's start with the proper foot. So check. What? Oh yeah, so we need to change that load on the. Okay. That is always good to check before.
Okay, here's something to remember about this circuit. The right-hander of turn 6 is the first Lesmo. You can carry a reasonable amount of entry speed here and can also get back on the power quite early. The camber gives the car a lot of grip, so you can take an early apex. Just be careful not to get too greedy. You'll lose a lot of time if you dip a wheel off the road.
Okay. Oh, look at this tires. So qualify is gonna be mixed conditions. Let's go. The rear is 6, so it's bottoming out there in the track. The car, I could really definitely feel the car bouncing there. A nice turn. Everything seems to be fine. What's going on? How'd that turn on? I had turned that off, no? Oh, open. Whoosh, completely wrong.
We're slow through the following corners, turn 1, turn 2, turn 8, turn 9, turn
the
11.
Tire usage seems to be going well. It's a hard chicane there. Whoosh. I start to see now the need of having more turn and how maybe the 6 on the rear as a ride height might be too low for me. I think I can feel the car bottoming out.
Test over, but I'm afraid we didn't get what we needed. We're gonna have to run it again. Assist disabled, you'll need to be mindful of your speed when entering the pit lane. If you hit the limiter line too fast, you'll pick up a penalty. Watch the on-screen prompts that show your target speed and distance to the limiter line.
Where is the pits again? Anyone knows how to go to the pits in Monza? Where is it? Ah, here. Speed limit 80. Okay, oof. Well, the balance in the tires is okay. With the setup, seems to be working. It can work, and the car can be fast. I need practice, definitely. But I think the ride height on the rear might be too low, a bit too stiff there in the rear as well. This does make the car fast, I'm sure, but to drive, to master that is quite hard. Quite hard. Track acclimatization, I got only one. ERS management, ah, there are nice things there. So let's check it out. Battery. So front suspension starts with the rear.
Our fastest lap is a 1:34.5.
4, 9. So 7. 7. Front. Here and 2, 4. 1727.
We're top of the speed trap, 335.5 kilometers per hour.
What about that? Let's see. Let's go with the hearts, it's okay.
All personnel be aware, car leaving.
Car leaving. Those curves are nasty. Oh, what? All over the place.
Definitely speed up a bit in the following corners. Turn 5, turn 6, turn 7. Solid handle on the lap. Let's try and perfect each turn. Remember that chaining good corners together will give you a consistency bonus.
Almost there.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1:31.9. Standing by.
39. That was weird.
We're second in the speed trap, 335.5 kilometers per hour. Checks complete. All personnel be aware, we have a car leaving.
2:04.19.27. more soft suspension in front really helped with those curves. That. And also helps with those the rotation here. We definitely need more practice in Monza.
We've had to spend time repairing the damage to the car.
Finishing the battery. Cool, so now we know what to do. Let's check it. Yeah, that's the old, which we actually need to delete. I don't know from where it's picking up that. Is it, this we're gonna change. 241926.
Okay, here's something to remember about this circuit. Top Same. Speed is absolutely vital here. There are so many long straights that we want to run as low a downforce setup as we can get away with. Mm-hmm. Nailing your braking points and getting out of the traction zones properly are going to be key.
Okay. And away we go. We're going to the hearts. Let's go with the hearts. Let's land it. Get a good run. Nail those chicanes, breaking points. Here, then here. Okay, here we have already an idea where to go. Opening. Now here. But if you get too much curve there, it's too high. The car almost flew. Now, late apex there probably. And here as well. No, there is a bit more complicated to get a late apex. DRS zone, forced DRS zone. And now here, the complicated part as well. So here, good, smooth, getting through here. Yeah, I think this is it. Down to the power, open, and yeah, that's a, we have different ways of doing that one.
There's some more time to be found in these turns, turn 2, turn 5.
Again, why that sometimes the shift doesn't seem to go down? It's weird. Not bad.
That's looking good. Now let's try for purple. You'll get a bonus for consistency if you can chain good corners together.
The brake bias was 54, so I changed it to 55 and seems to be helping. Oops. And the track, the differential now in 90 helped to not spin that place there. Oops, missed that one.
Right, that's the end of the program. Box this lap so we can analyze the data. Box this lap.
What was that? This is hard tires. Imagine this on the softs. Wow. 131. I'm third. Yeah, third. I was almost lost in losing there. It doesn't have much rear downforce, so if you put the car too much in the angle with no proper acceleration, it's gonna lose it. Oops. When we gonna have that engine green, I wonder.
Box this lap, please. Box this lap.
Jeff, you're late,
when
Jeff.
When driving with the pit assist disabled, you'll need to be mindful of your speed when entering the pit lane. If you hit the limiter line too fast, you'll pick up a penalty. Watch the on-screen prompts that show your target speed and distance to the limiter line.
Jeff, you're delayed, Jeff. Well, this time we got two at least of the track climatization. And
so far our fastest lap is a 1:31.4.
Okay. I'm gonna continue on. No, mediums. Okay.
When you're ready, let's go.
When you're ready, let's go. It is a pretty nice, fun track. Very fast. Not gonna rush through it. Let's master it as much as we can. The Yano Opmir setup is working really like a charm. Getting more and more used to it. Just need now to learn the track, the turns, the braking points. Get used to the track. When to brake, when to turn. Yeah, it doesn't accept to change it that fast.
properly utilize your overtake button.
Completely missing my breaking point. I was like a flying lap 3 seconds ahead. That was going to be my fastest lap ever. And I completely missed. Okay, dokie. This is the end for today. I think we progressed a lot. This track is fun. I think I'm happy with the setup. It's working well. Now it's just learning the track, learning, making my own breaking points and things like that. So let's do this practice again before going to qualifying, and I think we'll be ready for Monza. Canada is ready. Got pole position, but Monza we need to get better. So thanks for coming, thanks for saying hello. See you next time. Bye.